The Royals and Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Kansas City are teaming up to shut out the stigma of behavioral health. And I'm joined today by Royals pitcher Brad Keller, who's wrapping up his fourth season in the big leagues, which started in 2018, making the big jump from Double A to the big leagues. And I'll bet you get this question all the time. What is it like jogging out of the bullpen or coming out of the dugout in the first inning and there's 40,000 people watching you and television cameras everywhere? How do you shut that out, if you will, and get past those jitters?
That's what it's all about, you know, going out there in front of the fans. I know my rookie year, my debut, Blaine Boyer told me, he's like, hey man, like, this is what everyone dreamed of. Like, this is your time to soak it all in. He's like, you gotta, when the bullpen doors open and you start running out there, he said, soak everything in, because it's a once in a lifetime opportunity. He said, once you get on the mound, you have to find a way to block it out. You gotta lock it in and you gotta understand what you're there for. You gotta go out there and get three outs. So I think I kind of took that every time I went out into whatever game, whether bullpen or starting, whatever. It's just like those first like warm up pitches and running out to the mound, take it all in. Understand that all those people there to, you know, watch you go out there and compete, and you know, when we're at home, they're all behind you and they're out there to, you know, cheer you on no matter what happens. And you know, once you step on the mound, you gotta, you know, kind of focus in. For me, I like to, you know, have little cues where I look at Salvi, I look at the umpire, kind of like, you know, almost a tunnel vision type of thing, and able to actually like lock in and focus on. And I feel like as the warm-up pitches go on, by the time I get to my sixth, seventh, eighth warm-up pitch, I feel like, all right, like, we're ready for the game. You know, you kind of tune out the crowd and you start processing who's coming up. And as I walk around the mound, process, okay, what do we want to do, and go from there.
I think this would apply to just about everyone in life. You come up with a plan, and in your case, being a starter, you have 4 days to prepare for your next opponent. And then maybe things don't go the way as planned in the first inning or two. And of course, one of the cruel things that we do in television is we get a tight shot of your face, and if things aren't going right or when you're in the dugout. What have you learned in 4 years as a big leaguer of getting back to those things that you were just talking about?
The most uncomfortable innings are the first few innings, because you just want to like go out there, get your feet comfortable, get your, you know, base underneath you basically, and a little over anxious, a little, you know, added adrenaline. But when things start going a little, you know, haywire, if you will, I've really tried to learn on this like breathing technique where, you know, deep breaths really have helped me calm down when you know, your command suffers, or, you know, some base hits happen, or whatever it may be. I think that's one thing that I've learned, you know, my rookie in my first 2 years, it's like, seems like when a few things went wrong, it spiraled really quickly, and it was like, got out of your hands too quickly. And I've learned this breathing technique that kind of brings me back to reality, like kind of brings you back to where your feet are, and go from there. So it's been an ongoing process. I know this year is probably testing me the most about that, especially early on. But, you know, it's something that's going to constantly evolve, and learning more and more from it.
Salvi comes out in a tough spot. You feel one way, he might feel differently. Cal Eldred comes out and wants to talk to you in a tough spot. How do you take that breathing technique and then also process feedback at the same time?
Yeah, I mean, most of the time when they come out, it's more so of just like a, you know, just calm yourself down, give yourself a breather. You know, most of the time they come out with a smile on their face, no matter what the situation may be, or, you know, the score or whatever. You know, they're just trying to get out there, get you to calm down, and, you know, your mind's racing so fast because of, you know, most of the time they come out in situations that, you know, are big moments in the game. Your mind's racing so fast, so they just give you time. They, you know, kind of talk slow, talk like a nice, calm voice. They're not, you know, over, you know, eager about, hey, you got to get this done right now. They trust you. They understand that, you know, you're going through something that you've probably done before. They just got to get a little breather and kind of step back and understand, you know, we've been here. We got to do this, you know. As a starter especially, it's like, we got to get past this to get deeper in this ball game. So, you know, they're really good at being able to calm you down, and it's honestly up to you. Like you said, my breathing technique, when they come out there, you know, just with their voice, whatever, sometimes you don't even hear what they say. You just kind of hear their voice, and you're just like, all right, like, we're good. Kind of just like a little mental reset.
So let's say you come out of the bullpen, everything's going according to plan, you're cruising along, maybe you're even doing better than you're expecting to do. But what techniques do you use to make sure that you stay within your lane, or as we like to say, stay within yourself in sports so that you can be as strong at the end of your outing as you was at the beginning of your outing?
Yeah, I think one of the biggest things as far as that is like just control what you can control. You know, once the ball leaves our hands, out of our control. And that's one thing, you know, say you beat a guy, a little bloop or whatever, you know, it's very easy to get frustrated about that because, you know, you execute your pitch and, you know, the guy gets rewarded for it. If that keeps adding up, especially later on the game when you start getting frustrated, a couple of those happen, you're already dog tired, you know, then it kind of can spray on you a little bit and you kind of get out of your control. So that for me, I think that's one of the biggest things. Like whenever it's late in the game, you know, I'm tired, I really got to focus on my mechanics, but also not get too frustrated about stuff that's going on, because, you know, you want to push through that inning so hard. And then if you let one thing like that dictate how that inning's going to go, it seems like it's one after another, next thing you know, you probably didn't get through that outing like you wanted to. So just control the controllables and, you know, really remain calm and, like I said, for me, remain my mechanics.
Brad, thanks for your time. Appreciate it.
Thank you.
If you'd like more information, go to shutoutthestigma.com.